I've defined stakeholders as any group or individual that can affect or be affected by a company's purpose. Now, that definition is sometimes controversial. Some people say it lets everybody in, because after all, can't activist groups, web-based NGOs, a small group on the other side of the world, can't they affect a company? And the answer to that is yes. There's some truth in this criticism. That's a very wide definition of stakeholders. It comes from the idea that stakeholder theory is about business. It's about a strategy. And it says if a group can affect you, then you need to deal with it. Well, another way to think about stakeholders is just to define them as those groups that can almost always affect or be affected by. So you start from the idea that if you look at practice, if you look at a lot of businesses over time and in lots of settings, really it's customers, suppliers, employees, communities, and the people with the money, financiers, that those are the primary or definitional stakeholders. And other stakeholders, government, media, NGOs, interest groups, environmentalists, critics, however you want to put those groups are important because they can affect how you create value for customers, suppliers, employees, communities, and the people with the money. I don't think definitions are very important. I think what's important is understanding how the value creation process works in a business. And in business A, in the automobile industry in India, the value creation process may be different than in business B, a web-based startup in Silicon Valley. So the point of stakeholder theory is to say, let's try and understand who those groups are that are important to the value creation process.